In this problem, we're studying a block on a smooth incline, meaning that friction is going to be negligible here. And that block has a mass of 5 kilograms. The incline has an angle of 25 degrees. Now we're also pulling on this block with a force of 60 newtons. So we're pulling the block up the ramp, and that force is inclined at 30 degrees above the surface of the ramp. And we have three basic parts in the problem. First, we want to make a complete force diagram for this block. Second, we want to get the normal force on the block. And third, the acceleration. So to get started on this force diagram, there's the force of gravity pointing exactly straight down. And I'm just going to write it symbolically for now. We gave it a magnitude of mg. Now we need to decompose this force vector into perpendicular and parallel components. So there's a perpendicular dashed line, and we noted in there that the angle between the vertical and the perpendicular is exactly the same as the angle of incline. And I'll post a link to the video where that was first derived. So now we can view the components of the weight in these perpendicular and parallel directions. Now that perpendicular component is given by the adjacent side of the right triangle. So we're going to use the cosine for that. And then the parallel component, we use the sine for that. So again, for now, just staying symbolic, we're going to call it mg cosine 25 for the magnitude of the perpendicular piece and mg sine 25 for the magnitude of the parallel piece. Now, we normally don't leave the parallel piece down there below the ramp. We're going to move that up and attach it to the 5 kilogram block. So that takes care of everything with gravity, and we'll move on to our 60 newton force where we're pulling with a rope on this thing. So there's our 60 newton force vector, and we want to decompose this one into parallel and perpendicular components. And doing the usual decomposition, we get 60 cosine of 30 degrees for that parallel piece and 60 sine 30 degrees for the perpendicular piece. Now there's only one force left to put in the diagram, and that's the normal force. And for now, we're just going to call that little n. So now I want to start going through my diagram and getting numbers on everything. So mg is 5 times 9.8, which comes out to 49 newtons. And this mg cosine of 25 would be 49 cosine 25. And to three significant digits, that comes out to 44.4 newtons. Our mg sine 25, that's 49 sine 25. That comes out to about 20.7 newtons. Moving over to our applied force, I have 60 cosine 30 for the parallel component, and that comes out to about 52.0 newtons. And our perpendicular component is 60 sine 30, which gives us exactly 30 newtons. And the normal force is an unknown here. Now in part B, we want to compute the normal force on the block. And for that, we use a perpendicular analysis. So in the perpendicular direction, I have zero acceleration because this block is constrained to the surface. And that means all the forces that are pointing up and to the left, perpendicular to this ramp, must be balanced by all the forces pointing down and to the right, perpendicular to the surface. In other words, n plus 30 newtons must be equal to that 44.4 newton perpendicular component of gravity. So this gets all the forces balanced in the perpendicular direction, guaranteeing the acceleration is zero in the perpendicular direction. So we can quickly solve for n here, and we get 14.4 newtons for that. Now I want to point out an extremely common mistake with this normal force. So the most common mistake that I see is that students just get in the habit of saying that the normal force must be equal to mg cosine of theta every time. But the difference here is that we have a second force tampering with the perpendicular direction. So to get the normal force just right, so all these perpendicular forces balance, you have to consider that perpendicular component of our applied force. That's actually helping the normal force, so the normal force doesn't have to be as big as it would be otherwise. In part C, we want to get the acceleration of the block, and so this is happening in the parallel direction. We're going to do a parallel analysis of the forces here and apply Newton's second law. I can already see in my diagram that the force going up the ramp, that's 52 newtons, is bigger than the force going down the ramp. That's that parallel component of gravity, and that's only 20.7 newtons. So I know my acceleration is going to be up the ramp, and we're just going to call that the positive direction for the analysis. So when we apply Newton's second law, just a quick reminder here, that's a vector equation, and vector equations are true component by component. So what I want to say here is that F net in the parallel direction is equal to MA in the parallel direction. So in that parallel direction, our net force is going to be 52.0 newtons in the positive direction, and then minus 20.7 newtons, that's in the negative direction. And this is going to be equal to the mass of our block, 5 kilograms, times the magnitude of our parallel acceleration. In other words, the acceleration along the surface of the ramp. So we just do the subtraction, divide by 5 kilograms, and we get a parallel. And when I run the numbers on this to 3 significant digits, I get 6.26 meters per second squared, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.